Hello students, today we will start with the third chapter of IT, that is JavaScript. So let's start with this. Students, we have also studied JavaScript in the 11th standard, but again in 12th standard there is a unit of JavaScript with more advanced concepts. So I have written all the things accordingly. So try to understand all the things. Now what is JavaScript? JavaScript is an interpreted scripting language. First of all, you can also get a question in your 12th standard that whether JavaScript is a programming language, scripting language or both. So the answer is JavaScript is scripting language. It is not a programming language. Now the next thing is, what is interpreted language? You can also get a question on this, that what is interpreted language or whether JavaScript is interpreted or not. So the thing is, an interpreted language is a type of programming language that executes its instructions directly and freely without compiling machine level instruction as we did in most of the programming languages. So here the interpreted language means we don't need any compiler to convert the machine language or to convert the high level language into machine language. So it is a interpreted language. We can execute it directly without any conversion. Next is, JavaScript was initially created to make web pages alive. Here the mean is, I have told you in the 11th standard that HTML is a static static scripting language. So by using HTML we can design only static pages. Here the static means the pages cannot respond to the user. As we have designed the page, it is like we can't make any changes when the page is executing, or the we can't page can't respond to us, means we can't input any value in the page. So this problem was overcome by JavaScript, whereas JavaScript is used to design dynamic web pages. HTML is used to design static web pages, whereas JavaScript is used to design dynamic web pages or interactive web pages. Dynamic or interactive web pages means the pages respond to the user. When user types something, the pages respond to it. For example, suppose we have created a page to check whether number is even or odd, and when we execute that web page, and then on the output screen you have to enter the value. When you enter the value, it will display you the message whether it is even or odd. So that thing is, it is responding to your input. So JavaScript is used to design interactive web pages or make web pages alive. So you can also get these type of questions, that whether HTML is used to design dynamic web pages or JavaScript is used to design static web pages. So JavaScript is used to design interactive, whereas HTML is used to design static pages. Next is, the programs in this language are called scripts. The part which we design in the web page or the contents, what we write in the body part or in the head section, these all things in the JavaScript are called scripts. So you can also get a question in this, what the content is called, whether it is program or script. So we use scripts in JavaScript or HTML. So that's why the name is JavaScript is an interpreted scripting language. Next is JavaScript features. What are the features of JavaScript? First thing is, JavaScript is a lightweight scripting language. Now why it is lightweight scripting language? JavaScript supports some features of object-oriented programming language. Object-oriented programming language is C++ language, and there are so many languages which support the concept of object-oriented programming language, in which we make use of objects. Now, the next thing is JavaScript is not truly based on object-oriented programming language, means it makes use of some features of object-oriented programming language. So that's why JavaScript is lightweight scripting language, because there are some other languages which are truly object-oriented languages, like C#, J#, and C++ is also a true object-oriented programming, but JavaScript is not true object-oriented programming language. And the next thing is, you can get a question on this, whether JavaScript is true object-oriented programming. So the answer is no, it is not true object-oriented programming. And you can get also question whether it is lightweight scripting language or true object. So the answer is, it is lightweight scripting language. The next thing is, why it is lightweight? Because it supports some features of object-oriented. It doesn't support all the features of object-oriented programming language. Next point is, no need of special software to run JavaScript programs. We do not require any special software to run JavaScript. We can simply run it by using any of the browser. JavaScript is object-oriented scripting language, and it supports, next thing, it supports event-based programming facility. In the next video, I will explain you what are the events in JavaScript. So it is also, or it also support event-based programming. Event means, for example, when we click on mouse, the event occurs. So it is event-based programming. Next thing is, it is case-sensitive language. Most of the question paper includes a question whether JavaScript is case-sensitive or not. So JavaScript is case-sensitive language. Next point is, JavaScript helps the browser to perform input validation without wasting the user time by web server access. Next, this point is, means JavaScript always helps the browser. It makes use of browser to validate the inputs. For example, you have created a web page to identify username and password. So it means it is validating the user. It is identifying whether it is correct user or not. So this way, JavaScript is a very simple scripting language, which makes use of browser to perform input validation. Then another example is, for example, you want to check whether number is even or odd. So it is also example of validation. It is checking the validity of a number. So by this way, there is a no need to use web server to validating these things. So that's why it is a very simple language, which does not require web server access. Next, last point is, it can handle date and time very effectively. There are some more features. Most of the JavaScript control statements. Control statements means whatever looping statements we are using, another programming statements, conditional statements, if else. So these types of statements are most commonly similar to as we used in another programming languages. So it is very easy and simple to understand all the control statements, because their syntax is same as other programming languages. So anyone can use and understand it easily. Next is, an important part of JavaScript is the ability to create new functions within scripts. By using JavaScript, we can create new functions, and we can also declare a function in JavaScript using function keyword. We have to use keyword function to create a function in JavaScript. Next thing is, what is functions? Functions are predefined blocks which are used to perform their tasks. Next point is, the software that can run on any hardware platform like PC, Mac operating, Sun Spark, etc. Or it can run on any of the platform like Windows, Linux, Mac operating system. So when software is able to run on any of the platform, these types of softwares are called platform independent software. So JavaScript is platform independent scripting language. And next thing is, you can also get a question on this, that whether JavaScript is platform dependent or platform independent. So the answer is, JavaScript is platform independent. We can run it on any of the platform. So next is, JavaScript is also known as universal client-side scripting language. See, we can use JavaScript as a both client-side or server-side, but mostly or most of the times we use JavaScript as a client-side scripting language. So that's why it is known as universal client-side scripting language. Next thing is, types of scripting in JavaScript. There are two types of scripting, means we can use JavaScript in two cases, client side or server side. Now what is client side? In this type, the script means your program. The script resides on the client computer and that can run on the client. So basically, these types of scripts are placed inside the HTML document. The real life of client-side scripting is, as you people did in the 11th standard, we created a page in the HTML on the desktop and we execute that page on the same desktop with only browser. We don't make use of any server. So that was client-side scripting language, when the script resides on the client computer and executes by the client on the same machine without needing any server. The next thing is server-side scripting. Server-side scripting means when your script resides on the web server, means your script is not on your PC. Your script is on some other place, on some web server. So to execute that script, it must be activated by the client. It must be activated by the client, then it is executed on the web server. The real life example of a server side scripting language is online form filling, when you people fill forms online. So these are the examples of server side scripting, because the forms resides on some server, and when you fill the information, then they will again save on the server, and client is responsible to handle all the things on the server. You don't have any access to that web page. You can't see the contents, or you can't access that page or the contents of that page. You can only fill the information in the blocks which are given. So the one more real life example of server side scripting is online websites. Next is difference between client and server side scripting. You can get questions on this topic, that what is difference between client and server, what are the things which are on client and what are the things which are on server side. So the first difference is server side scripting is used at the back end, where the source code is not visible. So here is the first question you can get, whether server side is front end or back end. So the server side is used at back end, whereas client side is used on the front end, which user can see from the browser and user can directly access it. See, now I will tell you what is front end and back end. See, when you people created the web pages in 11th standard. You created a web page on the same PC and you are executing on the same PC. Means you, the code is visible to you. So this is front end. Means everything is visible to you. Everything is in front of you. That is front end. Back end is the things which are not visible to you. The code is somewhere else. It is not in front of you. And when you are performing action, it is executing the instructions accordingly. The real life example of back end is, for example, when you people use ATM machines. When you perform any transaction on the ATM, you can check only that things which are available on the machine, or they will display you the information regarding which they have provided you access. You can't see the whole details, how your database is updating in the bank, how the bank is maintaining its database. So all these things are at backend. So this is the real life example of backend. So server side scripting is used at backend. One more real life example of server side is when you use Amazon, you see only the contents, only the designed web pages. You can't access their code, or you can't see the actual code of a web page. So that is server side, whereas client side is what you people have done in the 11th standard. So the thing, you can get question on back end or front end. And there is one more thing, server side scripting is more secure than client side. Now next thing is why it is secure. It is secure because user can't access it, or by this way user can't change it or can't edit it, and if he doesn't have any access, then obviously it is secure. Next difference is, when a server side script is processed, it communicates to the server. See, when you people, or whenever server side script executes, it communicates with server. It collects the data or transfers the data to server. Or when you use client side scripting language, there is a no interaction between server. Means if you are using client side scripting language, you are easily executing it with browser. There is no involvement of server at all. So there is no interaction between server. Next is, the client side scripting language involves the languages such as HTML5, JavaScript. HTML have different versions, so I have written only the one, HTML5 and JavaScript. So JavaScript and HTML5 are totally client-side scripting language, whereas PHP, ASP.NET, Python, C# are server-side scripting languages. These all are script. PHP, ASP are server-side scripting languages. So if we have to use JavaScript as a server-side language, we have to use it with combination with any of the language. But we can't use simply JavaScript as a server-side. Next is, server-side scripting is useful in customizing the web pages and implements the dynamic changes in the websites. It means when we are using server-side, for example, let's take an example of Amazon, it is useful in customizing the web pages. Customizing means, as we have learned in the second unit, that search engine optimization, that what is search engine optimization, we have studied there that we have to make our web pages more customized, more effective, more attractive. We have to follow the rules and all the things. So whenever we use web server scripting languages, we always make use of customizing the web pages. Means we always make use of search engine optimization techniques. because when we are using server side scripting language, we have to display our web pages to the number of users. And when the aim is to represent number of users or to advertise any of the product, so it is one of the responsibility of the organization that it must attract number of users. So to attract number of users, we have studied that it is must to use search engine optimization techniques. So search engine optimization techniques are always useful in server-side scripting language. There is no use of search engine optimization techniques in client-side scripting language. So the client-side scripts are generally used for validation purpose. So we mainly use client-side for validation purpose. So you can always get a question on this that whether search engine optimization, there is a need to apply it on client-side. So the answer is no. Because we have to need or there is a need to apply search engine optimization techniques on only server side scripting web pages or websites. So next thing is you can get one more question that why we have to use client side. So the answer is for validation purpose. And I have told you in the 11th standard that most of the organizations make use of client side at its organization to validate some of the processes of that organization. For example, whenever any of the user is entering into the organization, he has to type its username or password to enter into that organization. Or whenever a user is accessing any machine or any of the software or hardware, he has to type that username or password. We can use it in that case, and there are so many examples where we can use client side at any of the organization apart from there is a need to use it server side. So special software is required to execute server side script. Whenever we have to execute server side script, we have to use special softwares. But when we have to use client side script, we do not require any special softwares. We can easily execute it by simply using web browser as an interface. So that was the introduction of JavaScript, features of JavaScript, JavaScript as a client-side scripting language, or the difference between client-side and server-side. And you can get many questions on these topics. And JavaScript is one of the important unit of IT. And as you people know, your question paper comprises of MCQ, filling the blanks and fill-ups. So this way you can get many questions on JavaScript. So let's start with the next topic. Switch statement. What is switch statement and why there is a need to use switch statement? I will explain the switch statement in the next video. Today I will just give an intro of switch statement. So next is JavaScript has a built-in multi-way decision statement known as switch. So switch is basically a decision-making statement. You can get a question whether it is conditional statement or it is also a conditional statement. Whether it is a conditional statement, it is a looping statement, it is a decision-making statement. So the answer is it is a conditional or decision-making statement. So switch statement is a statement in which we can give multiple conditions. We use switch statement where we have multiple conditions and we have to take decision that we want to or there is a need to execute which condition. So in that case we make use of switch statement. So it is a built-in statement. Built-in means it is built-in statement. We just have to use the keyword switch whenever we want to use that case. So how it works, the switch statement test the value of the given expression. It tests the value of the given expression. It tests the value to check whether the condition is true or not against a list of case values. And when match is found, a block of statement associated with that case is executed. It means in switch statement, we make multiple cases. And whenever we enter any value, it will match that value with the particular case. If it found any match, then it will execute that case. Else part is it will execute default case. In switch statement, we also make use of default case as a last statement. So there should not be duplicity between the cases. There will not be any duplicacy between any of the cases. Every case must be unique. The value for the case must be similar data type as the variable in switch. Now I will give you one real life example to understand the concept. Suppose there are 7 weeks in a day, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. There are seven days in a week. Suppose there are 7 days in a week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and you want to decide about whatever you want to eat on Sunday, on Monday or Tuesday. So you want to make cases that on Sunday you want to eat rice, on Monday you want to eat this, on Tuesday you want to eat Maggie. So by using this, you can make 7 cases by assigning 7 values. Case 1, Sunday, and the value. Case 2, Monday, and the value. And when you save it or make cases, then there is a no need to you to remind all the things or all the cases that whatever you have to eat on Tuesday, whatever you have to eat on Friday. You can simply enter the case value and you will get the answer. For example, you want to check what you have to eat on the second day of the week. So you just have to enter second. When you press second, it will display you the name of the food that you have to eat on second day. So by this way, switch statement helps to make decisions. And it is very helpful in that case where there are multiple statements and you have to select one from them. And I have told you that in this we also make use of default statement. For example, if you have made 7 cases and you are entering value 12, there is no 12 case in the your program. So it will execute default case in that case. So students, that's all for today. Tomorrow I will explain you the syntax of the switch statement with the program of a switch statement.